Right, welcome back to another one. I put a call out onto my Instagram page for people to send me pictures that they've come across when they've been working. So thanks to everyone that did send me a picture. There was loads, and I've condensed this down into sort of 10-15 minute video. All the credits are at the end of the video, so if you did send me a picture, I hope I've remembered to put your name in at the end. So we'll roll the videotape. We've got lots of pictures to get through. I probably will end up stopping this and explain a little bit more, but I will edit it to suit. So enjoy the video. Let's get on with it. Right, here we can see, this is obviously a consumer unit that's had several different electricians come over the decades. And I think I can see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 different manufacturers breakers in there. So we got a Square D, we've got an MK, I think that's a Proteus, possibly Hagar, Contactum, and a Crabtree. Yeah, all totally different. Needs a new fuse board, basically. Yeah, and it looks like you've got one RCD controlling the whole board there, which again isn't fantastic. Next we have I'm not sure, this guy messaged me, he said this is his house, so I'm not sure if he's an electrician, but this is the state of his consumer unit. Again, isn't great, there's no cover, I don't know if he's just taken it off of the picture, but there's some sort of tails jammed right in the front there, very undersized, all rewirable fuses there, so that wants a board upgrade. Again, we have the classic above a ceiling, it doesn't matter. I believe there's a few spurs just below this, and that's the feed cable on the right, and this is just being put in connectors, and then above there goes off to another flex, so they've sort of teed off the flex with connectors and then put the horrible tape on it, obviously to make it double insulated. Next we have classic light fitting. I'm not sure how this has come about, obviously. It looks like the original cables come in the back and then someone has sort of added cables in off the front, and the earth's not sleeving. I'm not even sure where the earth's going, but yeah, again, a little bit poor insulation there. So this, I'm not entirely sure. This looks like some sort of... right, let's start at the beginning. You can see the main tails there coming in. Someone has cut a bit of twin and earth 16 mil by the looks of it, so you've got a single insulation coming into an enclosure without a blank on it, and then you've got cables going everywhere, and it looks like doorbell and coax cables and stuff just sort of lashed everywhere. Looks a bit like one of those units that you get with the satellite dishes in. That's what that looks like. Aerial cables just going off all over the place in a riser. Here we've got a picture of a meter and then a load of tails sort of lashed in on a gas pipe. Maybe that's a gas pipe or an old gas pipe or central heating. They're sort of cable tied to the pipe there or sat on top of it. And then the next slide is, I think this is where the cables come around. Obviously, look, it's just really old dishwasher. So it's obviously some sort of commercial building. Yeah, just quite scruffy, really. Just needs updating. Here we have a nice copper light fitting. Not sure the manufacturer, but as you can see, it's full of rust and not very waterproof there. This one, we got the classic neutral burnt out. It looks either like a shower or a cooker switch. And as you can see there, the neutral there is completely burnt out, possibly from a loose connection and overload. Or not even overload, but just a loose connection has caused the arcing out there for the switch to set on fire there, the cables to mount. Next, we have the same switch, and this is what you could see from the front view there. Yeah, that's essentially the front view there of the same switch. You can see the brown coming through there. So this was this is a switch that's someone has removed. It's then got a back box that's fallen into the wall, and as you can see, it's got a weird round ornate sort of cover on it. Almost looks like it was glued to the wall rather than fixed, which obviously isn't great, and there's no earth, well, sorry, the earth connection is there, but it's not sleeved by the looks of it. It's not doing much, basically. Here you can see a classic above the ceiling again, connector blocks, not in any sort of box. So just poor practice there. I believe this is a new build, and this is what you get. There's no conduit, but there is a looks like a male bush adapter there, with a cable going straight in. So you could potentially stick something in there and gain access to that live terminals on the switch, potentially. I wouldn't be worried, but here we have the classic grey sleeving on the earth because they couldn't be bothered to get any earth sleeving out of the van. I believe this was a new build, and the people didn't get the new build garage connected. So the feed cable out was left like this for them when they moved in. So it was left in a junction box there outside. So that could just get soaking wet and then potentially cause tripping issues. Because I know new builds, they don't come with RCBO board. So that would trip off half the house, and you wouldn't be able to get that circuit back on if it was a neutral earth fault there, because it would just trip the RCD. So they potentially lose half their house there, which isn't great. I believe the next one is a light fitting. That was live. See the ends there just cut? I believe that was floating above a ceiling. You can see it's teed off and it doesn't go anywhere, and it could have potentially touched the light, and it was live there on the end of that cable. Again, we've just got a really old socket that's obviously been modified at some point. No grommets, which is minor, but as you can see, it's all twisted and it's really old cables, and the earth's been completely twisted within an inch of its life, so they've put the connector on it to extend it. There. So I believe this is a new board that someone has finished, a new consumer unit. So they've just put grommets in the top there. So you could potentially stick your finger in there. These next couple of pictures from the same person. Here we have the tails going in individual slots in the board there, which is a no-no. I know we don't see much thermal eddy currents from this, but it's still a no-no, and it should be going in a proper consumer unit gland. And this is the classic BG in-store from Screwfix by the looks of it. Look at the tails there. They're on the squiff, they're on the angle, and they wouldn't take much to come out, would they, to be honest? Look. Yeah, just not great, to be honest. Here we have European, I believe. So I have some European followers, which is nice. And this is a really, really hot. I'm not even sure what that is. Maybe, is it a switch? Yeah, so it's a three phase and neutral switch. And as you can see there, one of the phases is completely burnt out there. Correct me if I'm wrong on that. I'm not really sure what that is. Looks like a switch, Hagar. And again, I don't know if the cover's been taken off of this. It doesn't look like, but to me, that looks like exposed terminals, MCBs just screwed, and there's no cover on it, and everything's just been lashed into the front of it. Almost looks like an SWA I don't really know what's going on there. I believe this is that same switch picture. Not entirely sure. But as you can see there, that's where the loose connection, it's actually started to burn off the cable there, look. So this is the classic, haven't got a socket on the landing, so they've run an extension lead out and then they've decided to smash the door against it 355,000 times and damage the cable there. So Litland's fingers goes in there and he gets electric shock. So that's not very safe, is it? Again, international follower here. I'm not entirely sure what is going on. It almost looks like there's a cable coming in and then they've added onto it, and that looks like some sort of connector blocks with a flex and a potential pipe there. So I'm not entirely sure what's going on, but I thought we'd feature this one. Next one is a switch. I'm not sure if this has pulled out or has been disconnected, but again, looks like a flex outlet plate, and it just looks really poor, doesn't it, to be honest. Now this one, I'm not sure what is going on. It's obviously a shop consuming it. Someone's decided to put a piece of Unistrut by the looks of it. You've got a millionaire scratch card there. So he didn't win, so he was so annoyed he decided to smash half of the consumer unit up. So you can get to the right hand side, but you can't access the left hand side. And then there's an old rewirable fuse board above there. it all needs upgrading, doesn't it, and sorting out there. Next we have classic downlight connection, I believe. Yeah, no earth connection to it. If it is double insulated, you should still continue the earth through the cable, and the single insulation is been caught up in the sheathing there. Yeah, this next one is I believe it's a fire alarm inside of a freezer. I'm not sure who designed it. I'm not sure entirely what's going on here, but yeah, it looks very chilly, doesn't it? And the fire alarm was in fault, believe it or not, and I wonder why. Hey, iced up, I believe. Next we have, I believe, these cables were going up behind a skirting board and they've been continuously smashing and arcing out, and then eventually the lights upstairs stopped working. So I believe that's what this is. This is cables that have smashed against the skirting board. Here we have the classic outside light. It's not been fitted correctly and it's full of water. So eventually that will fill up and give you some sort of faults on your circuit there. Again, we've got light fitting by the looks of it. Someone's replaced the light fitting for an IKEA special, so they've just jammed all the cables in the ceiling in a connector block, which isn't great. Here we've got an SY installation. So we've got a load of tray and he's decided not to use the left hand piece and he's taking it all on the right, and it sort of loops out the switch because there's only two knockouts in the top of that switch there. So they've had to come out the bottom, loop it up. And that power socket one is even crossing over the light switch there. Look, it's just really poor, isn't it? SY is quite a nice cable to work with, actually, so you can dress it in nicely. And this is from the same unit. Look, the cable's obviously going over to the lights and stuff. Again, just really poor installation. And there's the Schneider consuming it there. And the cables have been wrenched across at an angle rather than swooping in nicely to the connections there. Next, this is a socket tester, and I believe this is the same place. I'm not sure if that has been loosened for the video, but we'll take it what it is. So that's really loose, isn't it? And I believe this is the plumber that's done a hive. Not slating any plumbers, because I come across some plumbers that do an absolute beautiful job, better than some electricians. But again, this is a junction box. It's obviously not big enough and the cover's just come off. So it'll have a proper little wiring centre there, or minimum a double socket box with a blank plate. Here we have a cable that's been lashed into the mains there, and I think this is like a bypass the meter situation. Yeah, we know what those sort of people are like. This guy didn't have a laser level by the looks of it. Look at that. I think this is Jordan's latest EV charging install. I'm not entirely sure. I'm joking. Here we go. This is a socket that someone's extended. They didn't have any junction box or Vargos or in ideal connection, so they've done a little double hook loop there and relying on the force of that to provide an earth for that socket there. So yeah, very dangerous that, and that needs sorting out, doesn't it? Next we have, I believe this is, I'm not sure where this is, but I believe this is open to the elements. This is, I think this might be a traffic light box where all the traffic light signals go back to. Obviously it's as scruffy as how and needs completely changing. This has got to be my best one of the lot, I think. This is somebody that thinks they know what they're doing and they haven't got a clue. So they've added in Henley blocks to the main tails there to give them an output. So, and then they've then decided to look what comes in, looks like a 4mm or a 2.5 SWA. So the overcurrent protection on those 2.5 cables will be the 100 amp or 60 or 80 amp main switch there. And then they've brought all the main tails into a metal box through individual holes. It's just crap. It's just utter, utter crap. That's all I can say about that, really. Very, very poor installation. Here you can see international again. Smoking, yeah? That's getting very hot in there. I believe this is a consuming it or a panel where the lid has been missing. And as you can see, the corrosion there. It's obviously been open to the elements there. Terrible, terrible corrosion. A smashed breaker there, look. It just wants stripping out and redoing again, doesn't it? Right, next we have... So this is, I think this is an EV charging store. So as we follow it through, they've come off the main switch there, put some Henley blocks in that are floating, they're not fixed to anything. So they can come loose if they're blowing in the wind. They've then brought the main tails up and into that top box there. They've gone through an RCD by the looks of it. So again, there's no overcurrent protection on that cable because that's a 61008, which I believe does not provide overcurrent protection, only RCD protection. So again, someone that doesn't really know what they're doing has had a go and ballsed it up, really. Because the original actually looks really neat. It comes out of the mains, goes through the meter, comes from the meter, goes through the main switch there and would have gone off to the consume unit. They then put the horrible Henley blocks on and gone off to their EV charging box there. It's just very poor. Yeah, horrible, in fact. Next, again, this is just, I think this is like an open consuming it. You have to be careful of these because the flash guards in the back there, will have rope and they contain high levels of asbestos. They're like one of the worst because it's so fibrous, it releases it in the air. And again, most of the fuses are missing there. So the little terminals that are red will be live. They easily come off those shields. So again, not great. And what have we got next? We have, so this is one of my pictures. I went to a fish and chip shop the other day and that switch there on the left has been added in by a contractor to provide a 16 mil twin and earth cable there. As you can see, it's just, again, poor. He's gone in from the Henley blocks. They were 100 amp fuses on the three phase there. So you've got no overcurrent protection on that 16 mil. 100 amps, you think that can take 100 amps? I wouldn't be comfortable with that. Again, single insulation outside of enclosure. And then he's put a connector on the earth there. Yeah, it's a shame this. It's a real shame to see this in my local area, but it does happen. And I know this guy is actually. It's shocking, really. And again, this next picture is the fuse board above. If you can see, there's the cable going up. And again, this has recently been signed off on an EICR as a pass. So, not very good there, is it? Again, this is one of mine. Took a switch off to find that it's a metal switch plate. And all they've done is take the earth up and put it in a connector rather than put it into the faceplate there. So, potential there for no earth on the metal faceplate. It could become live and you get electric shock. And there's no path to earth there. This one is a missing blank. I see this all the time. Everyone sees this. Missing blanks out of the fuse board. So you can stick your fingers in there and you could get a shock off that live bar there. And last but not least, we have the classic downlight situation. Bathroom fitter, shall we say. This was above the light there. So just need sorting out, really, doesn't it? Putting in a nice box there and sorting out. But this is the sort of standard that you get when you employ bathroom fitters rather than competent, qualified electricians. Yeah, so thanks for joining me on this one. Don't forget to subscribe, it does help the channel, and if you enjoyed it, give it a thumbs up. Thanks to everyone that sent me the pictures through, really appreciate it, and I'll see you on the next one. Take care.